All right, welcome to Central Baptist Church. It's so good to see each and every one of you joining us here this morning. If you are our guest, thank you for choosing to worship with us this morning. Following the service, our staff will be out front, and we'd love the chance to meet you and get to know you a little better. Hopefully, everybody received two things as you came in. One is a bulletin. Number two is a candle. If you don't have a candle, we do still have some more out front, and that'll be part of our service. And if you did pick up a bulletin, you'll want to be sure when you get home later to read through here. This has a list of activities and ministries and things like that that we would love for you to take part in as part of our church here. So take that home and read through it and see where the Lord might have you be involved in His work here. And we do have the connection tab. It's right here. You just tear it out and then fill it out, drop it in the offering plate later in the service. If there's any way our staff can pray for you, put that on this form. Or if there's anything that we can help you with, put that on this form. If we can rejoice with you and praise the Lord over something He's done in your life, you can put that on this form as well, and we'll be happy to follow up with you on that. So we have a very special Christmas service. We have the Christmas choir production, and so normally we'd say stand and greet your neighbor right now, but we're going to ask you to hold off until after the service before you go to Sunday school and greet your neighbor then. It's so good to have you here. Now enjoy the Christmas choir production.
The first one to carry the gospel when the angel brought the news of that precious little boy. Mary was the first one to carry the gospel, and that news brought joy, sweet joy. Mary was the first one to carry the gospel when the angel brought the news of that precious little boy. Mary was the first one to carry the gospel, and that news brought joy, sweet joy.
Shepherds watched their flocks by night and nearly fell asleep. Another lonely, quiet night, watching all those sheep. Until a choir of holy angels pierced the night with songs of joy. Good news I bring, for Christ the King is Mary's baby boy.
Mary was the first one to carry the gospel when the angel brought the news of that precious little boy. Mary was the first one to carry the gospel, and that news brought joy, sweet joy.
Hosanna to the highest, and to Christ His only Son. God's glory wrapped in swaddling clothes, the meek and lonely one. This baby boy will change the hearts of all who can believe. What the prophets told has come to pass.
The virgin has conceived. Mary was the first one to carry the gospel when the angel brought the news of that precious little boy. Mary was the first one to carry the gospel, and that news brought joy, sweet joy. Mary was the first one to carry the gospel when the angel brought the news of that precious little boy. Mary was the first one to carry the gospel, and that news brought joy, sweet joy. And that news brought joy, sweet joy. And that news brought joy, sweet joy. What child is this who lay to rest on Mary's lap sleeping, whom angels greet with anthems sweet, and shepherds watch are keeping? This is Christ the King, whom shepherds guard and angels sing. Haste to bring him, Lord, the babe, the Son of Mary. So bring him incense, gold and myrrh. Come, Shepherd King, to own him, the King of Kings. Salvation brings. Let loving hearts enthrone him. Raise the song on high. The virgin sings her lullaby. Joy, joy, for Christ is born, the babe, the Son of Mary.
Once there were three wise men who were following a star, traveling to Bethlehem from eastern land so far. They'd heard about a birth there, an anointed holy one, born to be Messiah, God's only begotten son.
Well,
that little baby, he was born of a virgin, he was sit down to save us and to bear every burden. He was God in the flesh, so let the hallelujahs ring. That little baby is the King.
Well, angels were descending on that bright and starry night. Shepherds came to see that child beneath that star so bright. That baby in a manger, in that little Jewish town. One day we'll rule this universe, creation will bow down.
Well, that little baby, he was born of a virgin. He was sent down to save us and to bear every burden. He was God in the flesh, so let the hallelujahs ring. That little baby is the King. Woo!
Well,
that little baby, he was born of a virgin. He was sent down to save us and to bear every burden. He was God in the flesh, so let the hallelujahs ring. That little baby is the King.
He was God in the flesh, so let the hallelujahs ring.
That little baby is the King. That little baby is the King.
Man, that's a good kickoff right there, isn't it? Hey, would you clap for him one more time? That was awesome, Quartet. Well, we have a few rules for today. I know often you don't have rules in church, but we have rules today, and the rules are that you celebrate today. Is that okay? Can you do that? I want you to find some joy. I want you to sing, laugh a little, and just have a good time today celebrating the birth of Jesus. Now, hey, in Christmas season, there's always hard times, isn't there? Right? It's not all some celebrations, but when we lose someone or we've had someone that's missing in our lives, it leaves a little hole for us, and we're so grateful for our friends and our family that encourage us. And today, Michael McCord is going to sing for you a song that talks about that just a little bit, and hopefully it will encourage you today if you're feeling lost today in this Christmas season.
December hasn't changed. This town looks the same. They still light that tree in the city square. There's red, white, and green shining everywhere. And I wish you were here. And I wonder, is the snow falling down on the streets of gold? Are the mansions all covered in white? Are you singing with angels, silent night? I wonder what Christmas in heaven is like. There's a little manger scene down on 3rd and Main. I must have walked right by it 1,000 times, but I see it now in a different light. 'Cause I know you are there. And I wonder, are you kneeling with shepherds before him now? Can you reach out and touch his face? Are you part of that glorious holy night? I wonder what Christmas in heaven is like. Thank you. Is the snow falling down on the streets of gold? Are the mansions all covered in white? Are you singing with angels, silent night? I wonder what Christmas in heaven is like.
Man, that is absolutely beautiful. Well, you know that not everything is sad during Christmas time. And one of those things that we love to watch is our children. Isn't that right? Isn't that? Well, that's exactly right. So we have a pile of them. If you're a child, come on up here real quick and let's sing a couple songs together. Come on up, guys. Don't be afraid. Come on. Where are you at? If you've got a kid, push them out. Shove them out here. In fact, I got a gift for them when they're done, so you got to come up to get that gift. So come on up, guys. Look at you. Don't trip. Well, look at that. Don't trip now. We don't need Joseph falling all over the place. That'd be bad. Come on up, guys. All right. So let me ask you real quick. I'm going to ask you a couple of questions, and you've got to be ready to answer them, okay? So tell me real quick. Let's see here. What are you wanting for Christmas this year? So who wants to tell me?
Go ahead.
You for? Uh-oh. What? You want to think about it one more second? What you got? You don't know? Okay, well, that's cool. Who else? Tell me what you want for Christmas. Come on. Who needs two front teeth? Who needs that? Are y'all scared or something? Your parents want to know. You've got to tell them now, right? What do you want for Christmas, sir?
I don't know.
Wow. Anybody don't know? Let's see. Who else would like to tell me what they want for Christmas? Which one?
Oh, there you go.
Earpods.
Did you get that? All right. Anybody else? Tell me what. Yes, ma'am.
Something that I can listen to music.
Something she can listen to music with. That is awesome. Anybody else? Something. Oh, yeah. You got your hand up over there. Let's see. What you got?
Nothing.
You don't want anything for Christmas? Oh, that is so sweet. I'll tell you what. We're going to sing a couple of songs together, but I want you to pick them, okay? What is your very favorite? And it doesn't have to be church song. What's your favorite Christmas song? You had one, I know. What? Anybody? Who else has a phrase? Yes, sir. Jingle bells. Can you sing it out with us together? Ready?
Ready. Here we go. Ready. Jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Hey.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Pretty good right there. What? Who else got another? Let's see. What you got? Silent Night. You ready for that? Here we go. Ready? Everybody ready?
Silent Night. Holy Night. All is calm. All is bright. Round yon virgin.
Any out? Does somebody have another special one they want to say? Yes, sir.
Santa Claus is coming to town.
Santa Claus is Has he come to? Did you see him up the other day on that forklift in front of Big Lots? I don't think OSHA knew about that, did they? My goodness. So, sentence.
Tell me what is it?
Santa Claus is coming to town.
That starts. Tell me how it starts.
You better watch.
Oh, you better not pout.
You better not pout. I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town.
This is the scary part right here.
He's making a list, checking it twice. Gonna find out who's naughty or nice. Santa Claus is coming to town.
This is the scary part, ready?
He sees you when you're sleeping. He knows when you're awake. He knows if you've been bad or good. So be good for goodness sake. Oh, you better watch out. You better not cry. You better not count. I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town.
You know, it hit me that Santa Claus is like Alexa. Or Google. It sits by your bed. It listens all night to what you're doing. It's scary stuff, right? Anybody else have one more Christmas song before we're done? I love to hear kids sing Christmas carols or even their fun songs. What's one that we, what? Jingle Bell Rock. Ready, here we go. Ready, everybody together.
Jingle Bell, Jingle Bell, Jingle Bell Rock. Jingle Bells, and Jingle Bells.
Y'all got it.
To rock the night away. Jingle bell time, it's a swell time. To go riding in a one horse sleigh. Jingle up, jingle bells, jingle your feet.
Yep.
Jingle around the clock. That's the jingle bell rock.
Man, you know those words on the screen are always good. Isn't that awesome? Hey, do you think they did good today? The kids did a great job singing. And if you'll go down right there to Summer, when I was a kid, every year we always got a brown paper bag from the deacons at our church. It was always, did y'all ever have that happen at your church? It's really cool. It always had an apple, which those don't have apples, so there's no kids don't eat them much anymore. And orange and nut was always in that. But we cut to the chase, and it's got only candy in it, so you should be fine, all right? All right, well, you guys have a Merry Christmas. Grab your bag on the way down, and then we'll go right into the rest of our service. Thank you. All right. So, as the children are going down, and as we celebrate, and as we talk about the fun things about Christmas, the lights and the music and the fun songs, we know that it's really about a story that brings us redemption, the birth of our Savior Jesus Christ. So today, for just a few minutes, I'd like you to travel back with us and remember the story that we celebrate today.
The story we celebrate today is the story of the best gift of all. It's a story of human yearning and divine love, of frailty and splendor, of holiness wrapped in a burlap blanket and royalty laid in a box of straw.
The story begins in a part of the world that seems almost forgotten, in the heart of a girl who is willing to believe. Hundreds of years ago in the region of Galilee, God sent an angel to a young girl named Mary, who was pleased to marry a man named Joseph. The angel told Mary that she would be overshadowed by the Holy Spirit and would bear a son who would be called the Most High, a son who would reign on the throne of David forever. Mary was troubled and afraid, but the angel assured her, "Nothing is impossible with God."
And so, as she waited and wondered, Mary drew near to God in prayer, asking only for the gift of his presence and his strength.
Ah. I am waiting in a silent prayer. I am frightened by the load I bear. In a world as cold as stone, must I walk this path alone? Be with me now. Now do you wonder as you watch my face if a wiser one should have had my strong, help me be, help me. Heaven, hold me together, be forever near me, breath of heaven. Breath of heaven, lighten my darkness, pour over me your holiness, for you are holy. Breath of heaven.
Now Joseph was a righteous man, and he would learn of Mary's pregnancy. He considered divorcing her quietly to keep her from public disgrace. But an angel appeared to Joseph also and told him not to be afraid to take Mary as his wife, for the baby was indeed from the Holy Spirit. This baby was to be called Jesus, the Savior of man and the Son of God.
What did Joseph feel as he awaited the gift of God's Son into his own family? What would we have felt? Amazed, perhaps, certainly apprehensive, overjoyed, but also overwhelmed. God was putting his own son into the care of a carpenter. What have I to offer such a child? Joseph wondered.
What can I give to this child of yours? How can I stand in your place? How can I father the son of the father unless you are holding me? Apart from the Father's grace, how can I do what you need me to do, or be who you need me to be? How can I hold this child sent from heaven unless you are holding me? Unless you are holding me.
Breath of heaven, hold heaven, breath of heaven, hold me together, be forever near me, breath of heaven.
Strengthened by their faith in God and upheld by their love for one another, Mary and Joseph journeyed into an uncertain future. They had been called, like the rest of the Jewish world, to pay taxes to Caesar in the city of their birth. That city was Bethlehem, the little town that ancient prophets had called the birthplace of a Savior.
Weary from the days of travel, the young couple at last reached their destination. And there found a dusty stable for shelter, because there was no room for them in the inn. That very night, the ancient prophecy was fulfilled. A son who would be called the Most High, God, was born to a virgin.
Heaven broke forth in a great celebration of light and glory. The sky above the stable was flooded with the unearthly radiance of a great, bright star, and the silence of the desert was shattered by the sound of heavenly voices. The night itself seemed to be singing with the angels, "Listen, Earth, hear the news. God's good will is reaching to all people tonight. A child is born, a gift is given. Come and worship him."
Fields of mountains and deep
that one amazing night in time, all the mercy and the power and the glory of God was given to the world in the life of His Son, Jesus Christ.
Yeah. Appear. we come to the close of this production, I want to spend just a minute and talk a little bit about what the birth of Jesus means. It's been awesome to be able to kind of slow down and take a minute and listen to the wonderful songs that talk about Christ coming and his love for us. I want you to think about that for just a minute. We've heard the story a million times, and I think we've heard it so much, sometimes we take it for granted. Unto you has been born a Savior. We have lots of ideas about who God is and what God wants to do in our life, and he's been very clear. He wants to save us. And so if you're here today and you're struggling, that's okay. There's been a Savior born for you. If you're here today and you're hurting, that's okay. There's a Savior who has been born for you. If you feel hopeless and helpless, if you feel overwhelmed, that's okay. If you're caught in sin and struggling, you have a Savior that's been born for you. I think one of the things that we miss as we come to the Christmas story is that God came to be near us. That's what Emmanuel means, God with us. I think sometimes maybe we feel like Mary and Joseph, that we have to make this long trek to find the place that God wants us to be, when in reality, God comes to us. And so God has come to you today. He is here today, and here is his offer. Love, grace, mercy, forgiveness, healing, hope, restoration, peace. And the list goes on and on and on and on. Whatever you need, God wants to give that to you today. God has demonstrated his love for you by sending Jesus to be born of a virgin, to experience everything we experience as humans except sin. He lives a sinless and perfect life because I haven't and you haven't either. And then he stands in our place. Stands in our place, and God pours out his anger, his wrath, and his justice on Jesus so he doesn't have to pour out on us. Here is the good news of great joy that is for all people. Jesus has paid your debt. And if you will accept his free gift, you can be free today. Jesus also offers relationship. And for many of us, we take that relationship for granted. Jesus is kind of like a fire extinguisher, just in case of emergency. He wants a deep, intimate, personal relationship with you. And I don't know what's going on in your life, but I do know this. If your relationship with Jesus is not where you want it to be, it's not because he changed. Or he walked away. And if you want that relationship to change, all you have to do today is take a step toward him. Now, we do this every Sunday, but we've come to the time where we have an invitation. And I love that word, invitation. I'm glad they use that word because that's exactly what it is. This is your invitation to respond to what Jesus has done, is doing, and will continue to do in your life. Your invitation. Have you ever thought about that? God himself extends an invitation to you. I want to be in your life. I want to change your life. I want to forgive you. I'm inviting you to come to me. How sad is it? We come in week after week after week, and we are invited to Jesus week after week after week, and we leave and never accept his invitation. Jesus is inviting you to come today, And here's his invitation. Come to me, all who are weary and heavy burdened, and I'll give you rest and peace. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for this opportunity to respond in faith to you. We ask that you would move in us today. Help us to say yes to you. Help us to respond in faith as you invite us into a relationship with you. So, Father, we thank you for this time. God, help us to have the courage to take a step into freedom, a step into forgiveness, a step into healing and hope and restoration and peace. Help us to make that step today. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Will you stand as we sing our hymn of invitation? The altar is open for you to come. Will you respond to Jesus as we sing? So much. You may be seated.
Before I looked for you, you found me. Before I knew your name, you knew mine. Before I spoke a prayer, your precious gift was there. One I never thought I'd find, the gift of a lifetime. That's what you gave. Your as an offering, my life to save, turning my song of tears to an anthem of praise for the gift that you gave is the gift of a lifetime. It's more than just your hand of blessing. It's who you are yourself that I need. So with an open heart, I now receive you, Lord, and the life you bring to me, the gift of a lifetime. That's what you gave. Your life as an offering, my life to save, turning my song of tears to an anthem of praise for the gift that you gave is the gift of a lifetime. Into the pain that I thought I could hide, you brought the gift of your very life, the gift of a lifetime. That's what you gave. Your life as an offering, my life to save, turning my song of tears to an anthem the gift that you gave, the gift that you gave is the gift of a lifetime. That's what you gave, your life as an offering, my life to save, turning my song of tears to an anthem of praise for the gift that you gave is the gift of a lifetime. I'll lift this anthem of praise for the gift that you gave, the gift of a lifetime.
Would you join me now in proclaiming the good news of Christmas? For unto us a child is born.
For unto us a child is born.
Unto us a gift is given.
Unto us a gift is given.
And his name shall be called. Wonderful. Counselor. Almighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace.
Impossible, given as true by the power of your word.
to you.